Hi, Nick here, and welcome back. You're probably watching this video because something went wrong or you're concerned that something might go wrong. So I hope to put your mind at ease by going through some of the more common difficulties and where to get further help if you need it. A common question we get is what happens if the Wi-Fi goes down during the exam. The short answer to this is nothing happens. In fact, short interruptions will not be noticed at all by the students or the teacher, and writing will not be affected. Everything will be automatically synced with the server when the connection resumes. If there is a longer interruption, a notification will be shown to both the student and the teacher in the monitoring view. However, the student can still continue to write uninterrupted. Should the internet connection return at a later stage, neither you nor the students need to do anything. The text will be automatically synced with the server. The case I'll focus on here is what happens if there is no Wi-Fi when the exam ends. We're teachers ourselves, of course, and we know that many schools have unstable Wi-Fi connections. An exam platform cannot be dependent on perfect conditions, so we have several options to submit exams even when the Wi-Fi is not working. If the student does not have an internet connection when it's time to submit the exam, a few different options for offline submission will come up. The available options depend on the student's device and the exam security settings. One option is to submit by scanning a QR code. This requires a second device, for example a mobile phone connected to a mobile network. Since mobile phones are often not dependent on Wi-Fi, this is usually a good option. If you select this option, one or several QR codes appear on the screen. You then simply point your mobile phone camera at the QR code and follow the instructions. The number of QR codes to scan depends entirely on the length of the text. It doesn't need to be you, of course, the teacher, who scans the codes. You could ask your students to do this themselves. They won't be able to change anything in their texts, as these have already been submitted in the exam view. Another option is to select Save File for Offline Submission. In this case, a file will be downloaded onto their computer folder where downloads are usually placed. When the internet connection has been re-established, all the student has to do is double-click on the file and the file will be synchronised with Exam.net. Note that the student will not be able to view, edit or manipulate the file while it is waiting for synchronisation. If a student's computer or tablet stops working, for example due to lack of battery or it just breaks down, the student can easily continue working on another device. The student can resume the exam using an individual exam key, which you can find for them in the monitoring view. If your student experiences that Safe Exam Browser has locked the computer with a red screen asking for a password, please contact us at support@exam.net. We can provide you with an unlock password if SEB was launched from exam.net. If nothing else works, you can do a hard shutdown of the computer by pressing and holding down the power button for at least 5 seconds, and then reinstall Safe Exam Browser. If you've accidentally deleted a student, you can find them in the trash can under the Profile tab. There you can restore material from 20 days back. Another case of accidentally deleting happened to me when a student accidentally deleted what she had written and then submitted her exam. In this case, the Student Answer and History tab is invaluable. Since each student's material is saved automatically every 30 seconds, I was able to restore her material up to the point at the time when she deleted it. We talked about video conferencing in the video on remote examinations, but I wanted to mention this again here. There are a few things to be aware of if you plan to conduct a remote exam with a video conference platform running at the same time. If you want to use the high security mode in exam.net together with a video conferencing tool like Google Meet or Zoom, we recommend that the students run the video conference in their web browser rather than using desktop apps, which may interfere with the lockdown application. For video conferencing to work on Chromebooks, you'll need to make sure to choose the lower security mode when creating your exam. If your students are using iPads, unfortunately it's not possible to run a video conference on the same device at the same time, since iPads cannot run two parallel applications in the way computers can. Currently, the only option if you want to be able to see your students would be for them to use another device, such as a mobile phone connected to the video conference. If you find a name in the list of teachers which shouldn't be there, a school administrator can remove this person. While an unknown person does not pose any risk for you or your colleagues, as they won't be able to see any of your exams, we recommend that you remove anyone that should not be there from the list of teachers. The most common case is that a curious student accidentally signed up as a teacher. To remove a teacher account, a school administrator goes to their My School tab, finds the person in the list of teachers, and under the three dots to the right, there is the option to remove teacher from school. Please note that above the list of teachers, the school administrators can also choose the option Manual Verification of New Accounts before new teacher accounts are accepted. We have several resources for you to use for all sorts of help and advice. As you probably already have found, we have a number of excellent training videos. In addition to this, we have the support pages that you can reach here. Here we go through the main functions, and you can also find installation guides for our applications and Safe Exam browser. We also have a forum with a large number of questions and answers. Just go to forum.exam.net and type your questions. And as you can see, the forum is available in many languages. Last but not least, we have an email support team that's extremely helpful and very much appreciated. All our support staff sit in the same office as our development team, so we're quick to identify if a case is acute and how we can best help you. I hope that your mind has been put to rest and that you can trust that Exam.net has solutions to manage problems that might come up, and the team is here to help you. And although exams run really smoothly most of the time, we're constantly adapting to challenges that may come our way and working to improve the platform further. Goodbye for now.